Hey everybody, it's Premier Gal. In this video tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you how to add open captions in Premiere Pro. So what I have here is a basic photo montage that I've created, and what I want to do is now add a captioning layer on top of the footage. So I'm going to go down and select New Item, select Captions, then click OK, then under Standard, drop down, you're gonna hit Open Captions, hit OK, and then it'll appear over here in your project folder. You can rename it, you know, anything that you'd like. Then you just wanna drag it over to your sequence, which is where you'll be able to see it. All right, so now you can see that there's captions on your video, but now it's time to edit them so they match your voiceover. All right, so first you're going to type in the first line of the voiceover. Once you're done typing it in, you're going to find the out point, which is where that voiceover ends. And you're going to type that out point where it says out in the captions editing viewer. Okay, now I'm going to type in line number 2. And the same way, I'm going to find the end point, which will be the out point of where this text will end on screen. And for the last line, I'm just gonna fast forward really quickly while I add that in. All right, so now, you know, this is kind of boring, right? We wanna maybe stylize it up a little bit here, make it bigger, more bold, more easy to read. So I'm gonna get rid of the background and lower the opacity to 0. That's how you do it. And I'm gonna make the font size about 100. And so this is what it looks like right now. I wanna change the font though. Let's go to Go Bold Bold. And that's what it looks like, looking good. And now I just wanna highlight town, and I actually wanna make it the color blue. So you have to select the text and the color picker. I'm gonna choose a sky blue there, perfect. Make town a little bit bigger. You can actually select individual words, which is really awesome. So that looks pretty good to me. Now let's go on to stylize line number 2 of the voiceover. So let's go ahead and increase the font size. And you'll notice with this grid here, you can actually customize where it lays on the actual image. So let's have it in the center. Take away the background. Let's go ahead and adjust the font again to go bold. Perfect. Make it a little bit bigger. So another really cool thing that you can do with text is you can add spaces or paragraph lines. So right now, if you just hit enter, you can actually create a new line, which is pretty cool. And you can make a certain part of that line, as I said before, a different font size. So now let's go ahead and change the color of Open Road because we really want that to stand out. Let's see, how about a green? That's not the best color. Let's make it a little bit brighter. How about that? Cool. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and just quickly fast forward as I finish up this last line here. So it's all about sort of playing around with the size based off of your own personal preference. So now I'm gonna add a cross dissolve to the beginning of the captioning layer, just like I have on the actual footage. I'm gonna copy that cross dissolve. So now it fades in really nicely.
Ever feel like getting out of town? Just follow that open road and take it all in.
So now it's time to render. Let's render it real quickly, and I'm going to show you how to export directly to Twitter with the new publish feature. So let's go ahead and find Twitter here. You can actually have a custom status, include your hashtag, just make sure that you're logged into your account. And voila. So that's it. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a big thumbs up. And please comment if you would like any further tutorials. I also want to note that this tutorial is part of a guest blog on PremierePro.com. So if you go to that website, you can check out the full blog. I've added a link below. Thanks again, and I look forward to feedback.